So everyone, this video I'm going to talk about how to put an item into a section state. There are a few ways to achieve it. Section is on the server side and it stores the item and its value in order to calculate query, process, validation, links, and etc. This video will cover all the scenarios setting the section state. I have one page with two items, first name, last name, and five right buttons, and one button. And each button represents one method. Today's video, I'm going to talk about one by one. Look at this button. First button, submit. Is using submit the page directly. Now I will demonstrate it. I input the first name, last name, and I click the submit. Then we go to the section sector, and we can see the mic and the link is just I input. Now I update the mic. And submit again, then we can go to see the item's value is updated. So I click the section. And how to achieve that pivot? Let's go to the page designer. On the left side we can see the two items and six buttons. And we go to the submit button. On the right side, we can go to the behavior property. The action, we need to set the action as submit page. The next Apex submit button. This method is using the Apex submit function. Now I will show you how to achieve it. Right click and submit. Then we go to the section and the item value is the value I just input. And how to achieve it? Let's go to the Apex submit configuration. And go to the right side and behavior. We can see the action. I set it as the redirector to your URL. And the target, we can input the JavaScript code here. Apex.submit is a function of the Apex submit. Okay. So. The third method is using dynamic action, but the third method and the fourth method are using the dynamic action, but the way, implement way is different. The third dynamic action are using the SQL to set up. And the dynamic action JS are using the JavaScript code to achieve it. Let's go to the. Then I will clear the section and I try it in the third button. Type link and dynamic SQL and go to see the section, the mic link. Insert it and update it. Then I click again. Then we go to see the section. Then it's updated. And the same as the dynamic JS. Then my and dynamic JS, we can go to see the section value. How to achieve it? The third method, I create the dynamic action. I use the SQL. The SQL action, it executes server-side code using the PR SQL. Because I just want to send the item to the server and return to the value. In this PR SQL code sector, I do not need to do anything. So I put now here. And the third and the fourth and the fourth are using the JavaScript code. First, I go to the page property. The page property here, I need to add the JavaScript function. I give it a function name, JavaScript function name, set section. And I'm using the Apex server process function. I give it a map process. I will address the page items. Page items is the two items in the screen. It will be sent to the server and stored in the server. This is the section. The page section will be stored in the server. About the Apex server process function, I do not need to discuss detailedly in this video. If you are interested in this function, you will go to the official website and look at how to use it. JS identification action execute JavaScript code. I call the JavaScript name, JavaScript function name, set section here. And the affected elements, I choose the items and return the two items. And I will go to the Ajax callback, because if you use Apex server process and you will execute the Ajax callback, because here I don't do nothing to do, so I put now here and point I choose Ajax callback. The last method is using apex.until package function set section state. Now I will show you. Okay, let's go to the section. We can see the matching value and how to achieve it. Let's go to the page designer. I find the apex until button. On the right side, we go to the behavior action submit page. We do a process. When they submit, I need to do a process. Now let's go to the process setting. And we go to the process setting. We can see the PR SQL code. In this process, you can directly use binder variable syntax to store the section. But today's video, I will talk about the package apex.until and the function set section state. Within package procedure and function, you can't use the binder variable directly. You can't use the binder variable syntax. Rather, you must use the V bracket quotation, the page items. Now you can see we use the apex.until set session state to store the item, last name, and it's wrong. first name. First name and last name. Yes, okay. And last name, I input a fixed value. And clear the section. Now it's done. If you have questions, please leave me a comment below. Thank you for watching. See you next video. Bye.